In today's Mass, there's the prayer, the collect for the day, talks about God's providence and that His providence orders all things in both heaven and earth. And then we ask Him to put away hurtful things and give us things profitable in their stead. What is this thing called providence, and what's divine providence? Here's a temporal example. We've got a highway out on the outside of the church. The highway is designed and structured and created for future eventualities. It's got a speed limit, it has roundabouts and all things like that. And it's designed to keep people safe, not only drivers, but passengers, so that we can go from point A to B in safety. Now that's a temporal example of today's spiritual truth. Divine providence is the governance of God by which He cares for and directs all things everywhere. He is the creator of heaven and earth and the universe, and it's all under His sovereign guidance. He governs then all of creation as a loving Father, working all things for good and the end result, which is to have individuals immersed in His love by way of the beatific vision. And so the question is really timely. Why then are some driving on the highway to hell in their life? The basic reason is that this thing called free will, you know, it's both a blessing and a curse. We sometimes choose the wrong. We choose the flesh versus the spirit. And so we can say that through choice, free will, some people are simply foolish. They're self-centered because they don't give a toot or a hoot about the grand design of life. They don't care about that. They just want to make their own mark on the world. And in reality, what happens is they don't make a mark on the world. They make a stain on it. Now, we as Christians choose the spirit over the flesh. But there are false prophets, wolves in sheep's clothing, as Jesus says. And we have to beware of them also. But Jesus gives us the why of it all and what we can do about it. He says, by their fruits ye shall know them. And so, the basic truth is, a person who is faking their faith is easily identified. And so it causes us to think personally, what are our fruits? Are they fruits of righteousness? Do they build up the church? Or are they works of iniquity, which tear at the very fabric of what it is to be a child of God? Ignatius of Antioch put it succinctly. He said, we should really live as Christians and not merely have the name. And so the question becomes for this day, are we driving the highway of life correctly, or are we one of those wrong way drivers? Christians do not bring forth works of iniquity. We can't. We're not designed to do so. It's not God's will. And if we choose to act out in that way, we are not God's people, but the world's. Our fruit is righteousness, and our King is Christ. See you next week.